torches of our celebration encircled the world. The tapestry of nations is weaving itself together. Come and be a part of the circle. Dance with us. Humanity has brought us together. Let us reach out and touch the stars as they light the way to tomorrow and bring us hope for a better world. We'll be right back. is in the beat of our drums and the rhythm of our footsteps as we rejoice together.
upon a star and dreams coming true. You are a part of our family and a part of the magic that is Walt Disney World. And now,
it's time to make
never lose sight of one thing, that we're all started by us.
The heroes of the day,
Baby
Tigger, they're all here on your way. Remember, that we're all the same. Come back to the back way. It's time to remember the magic.
Thank you.
Stopped up here. This is the first time. This is great. It is. It's now 9:15. The park is officially open now for 15 minutes. Actually, it's been open for an hour and 15 minutes. No offense, but you might just go there again. Not that I would get you in it, but it's...
Actually, when we get around, I want to move on to that side.
Upside? I think upside.
Recordings are removed.
Only went away.
Aerial Strato.
Why are they just standing there? Then?
And they've got the Triton squirting water. Pretty pretty.
Thank you. How are you today? Hi. Happy anniversary.
Stay dry now.
Video. Rededication ceremonies. It's now about 9:25 a.m. October 1st, 19th anniversary. New ride, Barnstormer. Oh, it is running. This is the very first day of this ride. Yesterday when we were here, but they're still building it.
Barnstormers with Goofy's ride.
Yeah, that's a ride I probably could, yeah. One more hour to the dedication.
A little? So, oh, Wendy Nespond, that's who you'll be playing. She's the female member of the band. Now, yeah, you probably guessed that. Now, did you know Wendy Nespond is what?
Bald.
She's bald! That's right! So congratulations! We're going to get to shave your beautiful hair today! Welcome to the Oprah Makeover Special! Alright, come on up here and get in your spotlight. Now, I could sit them backstage and get them into wardrobe, or I can have them audition. What do you think? Audition, I thought so. Now, you don't have to sing, you don't have to play any kind of musical instruments, but you do have to get jiggy with it. All right? So I need you to dance for me. Now remember, you need to spread yourselves out just a little bit, but remember to stay in your spotlight. And remember, this is a family show. That's another very important thing. All right, when I count to three, I need y'all to say, kick it, all right? One, two, three.
Cause I got no money, sitting on my hand, but I don't feel a hoot in my head, and the beauty, I'm covering up in skin. I got my hat, Jack, turned around the back, Jack, with a girl named Jack, jigging my head, jump back, give me a slap, Jack.
To wardrobe, and I have one more, our assistant will help you right there. I have one more very important role to cast, and that is the role of Quail Man and Quail Dog sidekick Quail Kid. Now, to be Quail Kid, you have to really, really, really want to wear the Quail Man uniform. Also, you have to say a line, and that line is, Quail Man, I believe in you. So when I count to three, I want all you wild and crazy kids to stand up and as loud as you can say, Quail Man, I believe in you. One, two, three. And Hunter, where are you from?
Miami, Florida.
From Miami, Florida. All right. Now, Hunter, what do you do for a living?
Well, I usually like to ride bikes.
That's always a good thing to do. It's good exercise, too. All right. Hunter, we are going to pretend like we're actors, okay? We're going to say that line like actors. We're going to go, Quail Man, I believe in you. All right. Can you do that for me?
Quail Man, I believe in you.
Oh, that was great! Let's give her a big hand! Great, Hunter. We're going to send you backstage and get you into wardrobe, okay? And the next time we see Hunter, he's going to have a belt on his head and underwear over his shorts. It's going to be pretty funny. All right, a couple of things before we get started. Please, no flash photography. Say that with me.
No flash photography.
Wonderful. Also, if you have a lighting attachment on your camera, please turn it off this time because it will mess with the visual effects of the show. And no smoking, no eating, no drinking in the theater. And if you're in the front row, please move your feet and shoes out of the way because Doug and all of his friends are going to be passing through here during the show, okay? Now, you're all part of a live studio audience, so I need a lot of audience participation. So when you see Quail Man, I need you to cheer. So let's try it! Good job! Now, when you see the mean, nasty, evil Dr. Rubber Suit, what are you gonna do? Boo, that's right. And what are we gonna do when we see Doug and all his friends for the first time? Great job! You are a wonderful audience, and let's give a big round of applause for Disney Doug Light!
Bye.
journal. Hey, it's me, Doug. I'm sorry I haven't been writing to you much lately, but I haven't had much to say. At least, not until now. You're not gonna believe what happened. It all started about a year ago, when we moved from Bloatsburg to 21 Jumbo Street. We were sitting in the back seat, and I was doodling in my journal. Remember, Pork Chop? No. Okay then, let's take the whole thing from the beginning. I start with a circle, and then draw a line. The line's the horizon, the circle's the sun.
Yeah,
then maybe some squiggles that look like a hill. The hill we drove over the day I moved to Bluffington. No way could I have imagined, while doing time in our car's backseat, that the best place in all of the planet was at 21 Jumbo Street. For starters, there's Peter. He's my best pal.
Who are you talking to, man?
And then, of course, Teddy.
Hey, you guys!
Doug thinks is cool.
See?
Oh, hi, man.
And don't forget Roger.
I'm rich.
He's sort of a pain. And poor Chuck.
And Tom Chippy.
Roger!
And all the kids at school.
I guess it kind of surprised me. Happened to move to Bluffington, and how on my first day here, I just happened to meet the most incredible girl ever, whose initials just happened to be Patty Mayonnaise. I've been trying to get her to notice me forever. But to Patty, I'm just another dopey shoes, floppy shorts, green vest and white t-shirt wearing kind of guy, I guess. The crazy thing is, I keep hoping she'll just happen to say something like,
you know, Doug, one of the best things to ever happen to us is you.
Yeah,
I think I'm gonna puke.
Just start with a new kid. Figure he's nice.
Yeah, right, the kind of doofus. Ooh, yeah, rich and Tim Slug.
Come on, Roger.
Yeah, man.
There's days when he's crazy.
He's always your buddy.
When he's a dialogue like that, and though it sounds sort of sad, I say
anything else can happen to me. 'Cause the best times a kid can imagine are as near as you're out to be.
And appear with the friends you meet
here at 21 Jumbo Street. Well, Pork Chop, now do you get the picture? Oh, man. So anyway, Journal, since my best human pal, Skeeter, is the only one who knows that I'm secretly in love with Patty Mayonnaise, he's been helping me think up ways to impress her. Well, you know, to show her that I'm cool. Most of the stuff we got out of this book called The Really Big Book of Dating for Boys.
Hey, you, Doug!
bam!
You're not gonna believe this. The coolest rock and roll band in the history of the world is reuniting for a concert.
The Beats?
That's right, Rooney. The Bodiferous Beats at the Bluffington Bowl playing there. Really, really, no kidding. Final farewell concert!
Woohoo!
And the R's truly the spaceman! We'll give the lucky 21st caller the last two tickets. So pick up the phone! And that the Beat Rock Studios know you are to play!
Doug, we got a call.
Yeah, right, Skeet.
Wait, we're serious, man.
This is crazy.
Where's the phone?
Oh, thanks, Porkchop. We're probably too late.
It's not too late.
Like, a kid like me is gonna magically be the 21st caller.
Caller number 21, you're on the air. What's your name?
Doug. Doug Funny.
Funny, Dougaroonie. Doug Funny Man. For your fantasy free seats to the Beat, all you have to do is answer one simple little question. Are you ready? Oh, fantastic.
What is the name of the song inspired by Chuck Lippman's painful gum surgery?
What's that?
Doug?
What do you think?
Doug Funny.
Skeet?
Doug! What is the name of the song in Tommy from Gonson Green? Hello?
Ow! Watch it, man! That really hurts!
That's it!
Ow! Oh, watch it, man! That really hurts!
The correct answer! Yes, congratulations, Doug Funny!
You and your special friend are on your way!
See my face! See my face!
I can't believe it. Tickets.
Blowing tickets.
To the best Beats blowout in the history of the world.
Yeah, Doug. Can you think of two more perfect people to go to the concert?
Oh, Doug. Beats tickets. Go blowing Beats tickets.
Patty. The moment I met her, the room started swirling. I finally fell.
Part of the concert.
Skeeter, you're one in a bazillion.
Oh, thanks, man. Oh, Doug, by the way, nice voice.
Oh, man. So, Journal, I decided to ask Patty to go with me to the Beats, really, really, no kidding, final farewell concert. With the tickets, Skeeter's help, and the really big book of dating for boys, how could I lose? Patty will be here any minute. What do I do?
Okay, it says in the really big book of dating for boys that a date breaks down into three easy steps. Step one, ask her out. Step two, show up. And then, oh wow.
What?
Step three, say goodnight.
Couldn't I just skip to step four?
What's step four?
Panic.
Oh, come on now.
No.
Think you're turning chicken hearted, stomach churning like it started, learning how to do the cha-cha-cha.
Yeah!
Cool! Says in here you're normal as a noodle, don't you know? Even though inside of you you're all but going,
rah! Thanks, Skeet, that was helpful.
No problem, man.
Hey, you guys.
Hey, Patty.
Hey, Doug. I caught you on the radio.
Really?
Yeah. And, oh, Doug, I had no idea you were so totally cool.
Huh?
All I said was way to go.
Oh, yeah, Patty, about that. You see, I won these, you know...
Two tickets, I heard. So who'd you get to go with you?
I figured, you see, I'm sorta asking someone who I kinda always wanted to, I mean, who's kinda sorta...
Say, Patty, how about you?
I'm asking Skeeter to go.
Oh, you guys will have a great time.
Yeah. Great.
So, Doug, how'd it go?
Skeet,
simply timeless. Anybody will settle. I mean, it's heater almost anybody will settle. Instead of feeling like I'm slamming up against a wall, a total loser. You figure any other kid can see how much I'm itching to be any other kid but me. To pull a switch and ditch the dope and blow a date with her. I'd pull off or wait with her as anybody else. Something else in here. What's this?
Helpful opening lines for boys to say to girls.
And they cover everything. Voice, laugh. Listen to this. Your hair is like the vast Serengeti at sunset, ablaze with splendiferous rays.
Oh, man, that doesn't sound like you at all.
Exactly. Here, Ski, spot me.
Doug, this is not going to work. And you know what? Carpenter, proper.
Hey, Patty, wait up.
Yeah, Doug, what do you say?
Your voice!
Your voice is a clarinet!
Your voice is a raisinet!
You laugh like Aunt Betty!
You laugh like Aunt Betty!
Betty!
Spaghetti!
Oh, baby side, Doug, spit it out.
Your hair, like the best Serengeti in sunset blaze! In a whole lot of ways, that would amaze even Rutherford B. Hayes!
Oh, our 19th president?
You guys are so crazy.
Yeah, that's us, crazy. Oh, that's it, Skeet, I quit.
Oh, Doug, you can't.
Every time I try to talk to her, I get all wonky.
I know Patty makes you crazy, man, but it's not so bad. It's just you being you. I think you should go for it.
You mean it's me?
Well.
Yeah. If I was anybody else at all, would I start feeling like I'm anyway 10 feet tall? Whenever Patty says, hey, buddy, wanna play some ball? A total winner. It's not for anybody else to say. Yes, then I should try and come up any other kind of way. Unless I'm honest with her, how can she agree to go with me to see the concert over anybody else at all?
Anybody
else?
Hey, Daddy Cake. Guess who scored 2 primo seats to the Beats?
Dad?
No, me. Me? Me? You wanna go?
Sure, Roger.
Hey, funny. Looks like it's me and Daddy. So no.
Oh, Dad. Wasn't there something you wanted to talk to me about?
Nothing. It was nothing, really.
Oh, okay. Well, see ya.
Yeah, see ya. Here, Skeet, take the tickets. I don't deserve them. Cause Skeeter, even when the odds were at an all-time low, I never really thought she'd go with anybody else. And it was true, Journal. I had blown it again. As I walked home from school, I felt like everyone was laughing at me, mocking me for being such a coward.
Planet Bob. He darts. He weaves. He wears his underwear on top of his pants.
Hey, come on. They're power briefs. Patience, intelligence, grace, and speed. Power's the covey of elders decreed. Clearly a hero will always prevail. Equipped with the qualities of the quail.
Qualities of the quail. Qualities of the quail.
Intergalactic ambassador of goodwill from Planet Bob. Quail Man is assisted by his faithful pal and trusted super friend, Quail Dog. Together, these two quail-line defenders patrol the planets in their never-ending quest to right wrongs and fight evil using the qualities of the quail.
Oops. Time for my routine perimeter check of the galaxy. Quick, Quail Dog, to the thicket of solitude! Whoa, let's see here. There's seismic activity on Jupiter's umbral moon. A meteor shower passing through the Kolsak Nebula, and planet Earth. Beautiful blue orb, second only to planet Bob in its peaceful serenity. The quail call, someone's in trouble.
Quail man!
Quick, Quail Dog, the quail zoom. Why, it's Miss Mayonnaise. She's being held captive in Dr. Ruffer's laboratory against her will. Evil can be so inconsiderate. Come, Quail Dog, fly away!
The Emperor of Evil be lurking.
Hey, genius, I'm over here. Come on, come on, right here. Your hair off.
You monster.
Don't.
What are you gonna do to me?
What? Don't flatter yourself, Miss Mayonnaise. I only need you to lure Quailman here so that I can destroy him with this.
A bike helmet?
Yes. No. This is the most nefarious device ever conceived. It's my neuron-numbing, confidence-crushing, cosmic... thingy!
It's a bike helmet.
Silence! Using supersonic ultraphonic radio waves, this little baby's gonna drain Quailman of his self-esteem and transfer it into my already overinflated ego.
How?
Funny you should ask.
Funny?
Suppose that I say, Quailman, you're a belt head. A burn like that, he barely even hears. But with my cosmic thingy, he'll be pelted with zinger after zinger till they're ringing in his ears. His confidence gets melted, it creams his self-esteem. And round about that time you're gonna hear me start to scream. Pump me up, pump me up, drain his brain and pump me up. Once his ego takes a thumping, hear me holler, ain't I something? Keep it pumping.
Never fear, Miss Mayonnaise. Quail Dog and I have come to rescue you. But first, I must retie my quail shoe.
As fate would have it, this act of conscientious grooming gave Dr. Rubbersuit the evil opportunity he needed.
What's this? It's stuck.
Welcome to step one, humiliation.
I see London, I see France, I see quail and I'm your face.
What's happening?
Quail man, don't listen to him. He's trying to steal your self-confidence.
Now, Miss Mayonnaise, sticks and stones may break my bones. But words can never hurt me. Losing self-esteem must become someone else.
And so, to stave off certain peril, the humiliated Quail Man transforms himself into Smash Adams, suave and debonair spy, an international personality.
Quail Man?
No, my dear! Her name is Adams! Smash Adams! Shield your eyes while the feet rubber suit with my devastating spoonkins!
Jay Adams! Smash!
Oh, this is worse than before! I'm telling you!
Quailman, you gotta snap out of it and go back to being yourself. Doesn't matter what he does, to set your spirit swaying, stick to being you, because no matter what he's saying, Quailman, you and only you can save the day.
And, yeah, having successfully completed step one of his nasty plan, Dr. Rubbersuit moves toward step two.
Ah, forget step two. I'm going straight for step three.
Oh, no. Not step three.
Oh, yes. Step three. Mindless taunting.
My personal favorite.
Listen to him, my friend.
Quill Dog, is that you?
Yes, I'm communicating with you telepathically.
Then how come I can hear you?
You must remember to be yourself.
Oh, get a clue, you two. Nobody cares about Quail Man.
I care, old friend.
Okay, besides the dog, nobody thinks you're special.
I think you're special, Quail Man.
Okay, besides the dog and the girl, nobody thinks
you're special. And I think you're special,
and
Quail.
And the announcer guy. Besides those three, there's not a single soul on Earth who believes in you.
Oh, man. Not Quail Kid.
Quail Man! I believe in you!
Thanks, Kid. But I'm afraid you're too late. My quail powers are all but completely drained. If there were only a few more people who believed...
What?
Everywhere around the world, and especially in the ABC TV theater at the Disney MGM Studios, everyone who had ever believed in Quail Man began to clap and cheer.
Now, you can't turn down your best friend. It's the rule.
But I turned you down.
Oh, for a girl. Girls are the exception to the rule. It's in the book, man.
Oh.
Come on.
Skeet, you are the greatest.
Ooh.
Wow!
Look at all the people!
Hey, do you see Cat anywhere?
Rock and roll sound station in their really, really no kidding final farewell concert. Here comes the Beats!
Hey, look at me. Hello, Fluffy Tower. I'm Roger Watts. I'm Richard on stage. Hey, I'm Richard on stage. Rock and roll. Thank you.
Best beats blowout.
In the history of the world.
Hey, guys. Wait up.
Hey, Patty.
A cool concert, huh?
Yeah. It was a little short, though. So, you guys walking home?
Doug!
What?
Step three! Say goodnight, like it says in the book.
Bookskeet, maybe I should forget about the book and just be myself.
Be yourself! Now, why didn't I think of that?
You did.
Oh, cool. Hey, you two. I'm gonna go buy a new Beats t-shirt. See ya.
See ya, Skeeter.
Hi. I am glad we bumped into each other tonight.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah? And I really liked their last song, did you?
Oh, yeah! Yeah!
Yeah! Yeah!
Yeah!
Yeah!
Come on, you like their American dirt!
Skeet thought we had great seats.
Roger thought he and I were on a date date.
You did? A date date? That's crazy talk.
Well, yeah, Doug, I only went because Roger had an extra ticket and I thought it'd be fun. And it was, till Roger went berserk.
So it wasn't a date date?
No, silly. A date date would be like if somebody I really liked came up to me and was standing there like you are now. And we knew we liked each other, so he asked me to go skating.
Skating?
Yeah.
With someone like me?
Sure. We would go on a Saturday, so we wouldn't have to worry about it.
Me? Someone like me? She wants someone like me. Has a dream. She's willing to trust to somebody just like me. Me. She said like me. Said it and suddenly every doubt just crumbled to dust. Felt my heart busting free, knowing I'm the someone. Over time, she'll see as the kind of someone loves me to a T. Someone like me.
And though it sounds sort of sad,
not again,
it only figures that agenda. Street.
Hey guys, let's go to Swirly.
Not a bad idea. Yourself. Cool theme, Doug.
Hey, why do you think they call it a theme park?
Hey, you guys, let's hear it for the cast of Disney's Doug Live. Valentine, Roger Plot, Patty Manning, and Doug Bunny. Please exit through the doors to your left, and remember to take all belongings, especially children, with you as you go. Goodbye, everyone. Thanks for coming. Have a great day, and remember, we'll see you real soon.